According to the approved annual budget estimates for the next financial year 2023-2024, the health sector has continued to suffer budget cuts. Women legislators have expressed worry that the budget cuts in the health sector amidst a human resource crisis is a bad signal. The poor are likely to suffer hurdles in accessing health services throughout the next financial year, as it is already witnessed by the continuous strikes by the intern doctors.
Don't recruit for health. You're simply telling Ugandans to stay at home and not to come to your health facilities. People will be retiring, people will be dying, people will be moving on, and the need for recruitment is high on health than it would be on any other sector.
People in Bukuya Health Center for usually go there, especially the mothers, and they will tell me that if they dare go there to give birth on a Sunday, they will not find any midwife. They will not find any nurse there. Because the nurses have been burnt out throughout the whole week. They are also taking residence over the what? The weekend. But you don't have replacements for them when they leave. That means the low staffing largely affects so many hospitals and health centers. And this is something we need to focus on as a country.
The budget cuts in the health sector have also not spared the funds allocated to the Cancer Institute and the Uganda Blood Transfusion Services.
Fortunately, while the Health Committee of Parliament had proposed a progressive increase in budget allocation for blood, surprisingly, it has dropped this year to 21 billion shillings. That means that there will be more mothers who will be in health facilities and are not able to get blood. And that means, of course, death. I have talked to doctors who say sometimes there's nothing you can do. You just have to see a life.
They have challenged the government to prioritize the redress of these gaps. They too vowed to block the passing of any supplementary budget, which will not be containing health components. Civil society activities under the umbrella body of the Forum for Women in Democracy also called for more support for gender equality in education, expressing a need for the increased funding to support community services department in the local government.
There are several areas where gender priorities have been allocated grossly inadequate funding, and this risks undoing some of the gains made in promoting gender equality and equity. We call upon the government to prioritize the redress of these gaps and enhance inclusivity in the budget.
The concerns by the women legislators and the civil society activists come in timely when the parliament is set to read the national budget. Story by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.